It was in this peaceful village of Debenna that Abel Mesfin's incredible story of survival began.
Most of his wounds have actually healed up. He had a large flap from the top of his skull, which was taken and was hanging down the side of his head. Well, as you can see, he doesn't have a top lip at all. The bottom jaw has completely gone as well.
5 months ago, 5-year-old Abel was attacked by a hyena. Hyenas are opportunistic hunters, and Abel, who was playing outside his family home, was just in the wrong place at the wrong time. Now he'll be undergoing surgery to have his face reconstructed. Abel's mother chased the hyena and rescued her son, who was rushed to hospital in the nearest town and seen by Dr. Mohammed.
Well, I can remember it vividly. It was quite a horrible type of injury. Part of his face, part of his jaw, and part of his ear was eaten away. And at that time, he was unconscious, so we had to take him to the intensive care unit and to resuscitate him and to intubate him. He was in a very critical stage. I was afraid that he would pass away here, but we tried to do whatever we can.
With his lower jaw and muscles torn away, there was a danger that his windpipe might collapse. So Dr. Mohammed performed an emergency operation, inserting a small metal frame to hold his airway open.
And the supporting structures are not present, they are absent. So what we did was, we put that frame so that it will not collapse and prevent the air from coming in.
Desperate to save him, his dad insisted he should be sent to a major hospital in Addis Ababa, 8 hours' drive away.
I thought that he would pass away on the way to Addis. I gave him only 10% of survival chance.
After almost 5 months in intensive care, Abel is now at the Menegesha Rehabilitation Center.
I couldn't believe how much damage had been done to this poor boy, and how he survived and how he continues to survive is a miracle, really.
Volunteer surgeons working for the Facing Africa charity are hoping to start rebuilding his face.
As you can see, the muscles that we need for swallowing as well have been affected here, but the surgeons are very hopeful that what they'll do is remove a bone here from the leg and reform the jaw.
Even though it's unknown if surgery will work, the operation has been scheduled to take place within the next few days. Taking time to play with their fun-loving boy, Abel's parents are making the most of the moments they do have together. But just a day before the operation, news from the hospital is that surgery has been put on hold.
Obviously, the surgeons are waiting on equipment to arrive because they, you know, there's various bits and pieces that they don't have available, which is delaying surgery at the moment. But hopefully, once that arrives, they'll see to him as soon as possible.
With nowhere else to get treatment, Abel's parents will wait as long as they need for the help to come. The whole of his bottom jaw, tongue and right ear was torn away. Given just a 10% chance of survival, he's proved to be a fighter and is now on his way to hospital in Addis Ababa to see if his face can be rebuilt. Surgeon Kelvin Meisen is in Ethiopia with the Facing Africa charity to perform Abel's operation, which has been 3 months in the planning.
When we first saw Abel's pictures, we were quite horrified. We had many concerns about his treatment and whether we could do anything good for him here. But we feel that it's worth trying to make him a new jaw so that we can get him to swallow and then hopefully eat fairly normally. So we're planning on reconstructing his lower jaw using the skin and bone from his lower leg.
There are two long bones in the lower leg. The fibula on the outside can be almost entirely removed without affecting the ability to walk. Using CT scans of Abel's head, specialists have created a detailed plan for how to reconstruct his new jaw using his fibula. Kelvin and his team are using that plan in today's surgery, starting with preparation of the jaw area.
So the blue area is the jawbone that's been left behind by the hyena. We then move on to the next part of the process, which is the red area, and that is the part of the jawbone that's either infected or damaged by the hyena, and we plan to cut those bits away to make a flush fitting for the new jawbone.
It's gone really well, actually. We thought it would be much more difficult than it has been. There's been a lot of scar tissue, but we expected that. The bone's been of good quality. We've managed to find vessels in the neck. So actually, we're exactly where we want it to be at the moment. So far, so good.
The second phase involves using Abel's fibula to create his jaw. They are cutting three pre-measured lengths of the bone, which will fit into a bespoke titanium plate that will then become his new jaw. Once the fibula is cut, the doctors start to construct and fit Abel's new jaw. After a complicated operation, the surgery is finally complete. It's difficult for Abel's parents to see their boy like this. But lead surgeon, Kelvin Meisen, is confident about the outcome.
It's a new jaw now. And it's time to come forward.
It'll be a long night waiting for Abel to wake up. Just 2 days after the operation, Abel is already using his new jaw.
There we go. Moving.
It's 4 months later. Abel and his family have moved into their new home on the outskirts of Addis Ababa. Abel has found new friends and is showing glimmers of the playful boy he used to be. Abel's wounds have healed well. The bone from his fibula has fused with his jaw, and the skin has transplanted well. So he now has a basic jaw and chin.